Starting this vlog off a little bit later in the night, you can see that I have my lights going on in the library. I actually haven't had a lot of time to really hang out in here and just read, even though I have been reading here and there, but I've just been still a little bit too busy. Hopefully I'm gonna get a little bit more downtime so that I can relax and enjoy some time in the library. I'm gonna turn this down just because I'm always turning the TV down. I mean, obviously I wanna hear it, but when I do pick up the camera, you know, YouTube doesn't really like that. We are still on out-of-towners. I don't know what to tell you guys. I do need to get some batteries into those LED candles. They are on timers, but I think they're kind of done, so I just need to fill it in. We still have the Easter, obviously. We still have the spring and Easter stuff up. I also need to plan out my DIYs because I want to do some Dollar Tree DIYs for my main channel subscribers. Here's Loxie. There's Hopper and Steve. She just got her walk. I'm going to take her on another walk, even though, what time is it? It's 7 o'clock. Yeah, I'm still going to take her on another walk a little bit later. My daughter is home. So she did get home earlier and she's upstairs. She just did some laundry. I'm sure she's taking a shower. She's taking a load off. Let's go ahead and, you know, do the nighttime routine for my bedroom, which is basically turning on these lamps. Just gives it a nice cozy glow. And I never skip this step. So get this one on. I don't turn this on till a little bit later. I'm also trying to do better about turning on my humidifier and also charging my phone. I don't know why, but I've been getting really annoyed with myself at kind of some of the laziness, like things that I do, and I'm just like, the cord is right there next to the bed. Why is it hard for me to reach down, grab it, and plug it into my phone? I don't know. Do I go for Frasier, I Love Lucy, or do I set some kind of like ambiance thing? My favorite seasons right now are like 1 through 3, so first, second, and third, but pretty random information. But yeah, so I did make my bed today. I didn't vlog any at all today, and I realized it's Sunday. I didn't put up a Sunday video. Yeah, it's just hard. It's a lot harder maintaining two channels more than I thought, and I really do need my craft room to come together because I'm also gonna use it a lot as like my business room too, not just like my office. Sorry for it looking a little bit orange, but I wanna use it to plan videos and do stuff like that. My office, I do editing and I do like all of my like personal stuff. But I really want my craft room to be a space where, you know, I can really devote a lot of my time to figuring out how to handle my channel, because there's a lot of areas. I was gonna come over here and get a book. There's a lot of areas where I just feel like I need to do a ton of improving. Just the lighting just gets really bright and dark at the same time. But yeah, just a lot of things that I feel like I have been backburning and I haven't just had a chance to breathe, and I need to figure all that out, to be honest, because I feel like I find myself saying, like, the reason why I haven't done this is because I've been so busy in this, and I am, but I need to get to a point where I'm also kind of living. I don't even know if this makes sense, but and using my time better, I guess you could say. Not that I'm not, but I just feel like there's a couple of things I just feel like I need to tweak from just a personal perspective and how I spend my time there, and also how I handle my YouTube channel. I placed an order today for Shein, so I thought it might be fun if I showed you guys what I got. All right, so the first thing are these shorts. I've actually ordered some shorts from Shein before, and I really like them. They're not like the best fitting on me or the ones that I had ordered, but overall I still really liked them. So these are the ones that I ordered. I also got this swimsuit. I read the reviews, always read the reviews on Shein, and pretty much all the reviews, are actually all of them, I think, people raved about it. They posted pictures of themselves in it, so it looked just like the photo. And I love one pieces, and I also love when they have like the full coverage, but they're still cute with detail. So I love the like the string bows there and that side detail. And then another thing that I look for is a decent coverage on the back. I know that the swimsuit nowadays, it's like, you know, nowadays the swimsuits that are very trendy, there's a lot of booty, but it's not, like, I like some coverage there, so I feel like this one's gonna be pretty decent. I also got it in this neon yellow, see, there's the coverage. I also got it in this neon yellow color because, I mean, I love yellow. It's looking pretty green on camera, and honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if it came here and had, like, a neon yellow green moment, but how cute is this bathing suit? And also, I love the line here. I like that it's not like heart-shaped or scooped. I love the line across. And another pair of shorts, I just couldn't resist. I thought these little white daisies were so cute that I had to get these. And then I also got this basic white cami. I talked about somewhere what my style was going to be for this summer. It's going to be a lot of like whites, blacks, browns, tops like this basically, and I'm also going to do graphic tees as well. So that's, oh, and kimonos. So I feel like this would be really cute with, you know, those jean shorts, and then I could throw on a kimono over this and put on my gold jewelry. I could style it a little bit up, a little bit down. It'll just work, and it does come in a bunch of different colors. It's $7, like, are you kidding me? And then I also got this swimsuit. I'm hoping that it's going to be as cute as it looks, and I love that Shein is doing this, like, pair set with, you know, the top, the bottom. They're adding skirts and all kinds of fun stuff to their swimsuit this year, and I love this print. It honestly gives me 80s vibes like none other, so you know I'm just going to be drawn to this. The one thing I will say is I'm not a fan of this like belt part, but if I love this swimsuit enough, like if I like the fit, I'm probably going to remove the belt part. Probably looks like it's sewn in on the sides. We'll have to see if it, yeah, because it doesn't look like there's a strap on the back, but that's fine. I mean, I'll literally just take scissors to it. But yeah, so really cute bathing suit. And also, you can always tell how much coverage you get in the back by how much, you know, from the front, because the swimsuit nowadays is the back is exactly like the front. So, which is fine. Like, if you love it, go for it. It's just, I do like more coverage there. I don't know. Maybe I'm just used to it because of the time I grew up in. I don't really know. Now, this swimsuit, the moment I saw it, this was honestly the whole reason for this order, was this swimsuit. I love this, like, paisley print. It's got the knot detail, so it's, like, little bandeau. I love that the print's also on the inside, but I'm not sure that it's reversible, per se. I don't think it's, like, any sort of different print on the inside, you know, that is on the outside, but it's so pretty. It's $13 for both. Okay, like at most places, that would be like the price for one. And that's on the cheaper scale, you know, like somewhere like Walmart. So, and I have ordered Shein swimsuits before, and they've been pretty darn good. For me, I guess. Everyone's got, you know, different tastes. And the last thing is just this ruffle top. Yeah, just pretty plain. But I love the feminine detail. So I think it's really cute. She's wearing it with some jean shorts. So I really like that. It's a pretty plain top. But I'm drawn to this like blue and white thing too. So whenever I see tops that have this color combo, I usually always find myself looking at it and putting it in the cart and stuff. So See, this is all new for me. I have no idea why this camera is showing the house looking so yellow when I'm looking at it, it does not look like this at all. But it's starting to brighten up a little bit. Yeah, it's definitely getting a lot better. But anyway, so this is what I've been doing. This vlog is probably going to be a combination of tonight and tomorrow so that I can get this up for Monday night. But so far, not really much going on.
So funny. Yeah.